Hello everyone, I'm Ben2M2. Welcome to yet another Magic the Gathering Duels of the Planeswalkers 2014 video. Today we're going to do part 2 of our video to unlock the Guardians of Light deck as fast as possible. In part 1 you saw which cards I took out to make a very lean and mean deck that plays really fast and tries to kill the zombie deck as fast as you can. I made that video this morning. I used the deck as I set it up in the video after that, and I won 10 straight games in a row without losing. So now we have 20 cards unlocked, and I've tweaked it a little more, took out some cards after getting some more experience with this deck against the zombie deck. So I'm going to be sharing those findings with you. I'm going to give you my vision on how to unlock this deck as fast as possible. So let's go to the deck manager and I'll explain which cards I took out. Again, I'm keeping a 60 card deck with 25 land. I think that's a very nice balance. Let's see. Well, as you can see in part 1, we took this one out. This is a new card we unlocked. Can search for an enchantment card, reveal it and put it in your hand. It's useful but not useful enough to take a 3 mana card spot in my deck. I think this card is a little bit too slow for my deck because it's really fast and really deadly now. So I think this I can do without this one. Same goes for this card. For 4 mana I can also play a very big enchantment or something else. So it's nice to make a character or a creature indestructible, but it's not really useful against the zombies, so I'm not putting this one in either. Then we have the Sigil of the Empty Throne. Sigil, it's a useful card, but it's too slow for this deck again. 5 mana. By that time, I want to be able to kill the zombie deck, so too slow. Same for this card, very nice card. I debated whether or not to put it in because it allows me to take out my my strongest enchantments and win the game. So basically, this is a you win card, but it's a little bit too expensive by that time. We're winning already, if all things go as planned. Way too expensive. Explained why I didn't put this one in part 1. Same for this. This one as well. These as well. I also took out the pacifism. We have 4 of those in our deck, and of course it's a good card to disable any creature, but by now this deck is so strong against the zombie deck that I don't need them, basically. For the same 2 mana I can play another enchantment, and I think we can do without them as well. So took those 4 out, took these out, you can see in video 1 why, and I took this one out. Of course, having flash is nice, but again, we're going to want to have the initiative and boost our creatures as much as we can early on. Make sure they get flying and just bash the zombie deck. So I put this one out as well. So that's what we have. Let's have a quick look at what we do have. That's always fun. Of course, this allows me to draw a card, and it grows when you put enchantments on it. Well, standard creatures here. This is, I think, the best card of the deck. It only costs 2 mana, and I always have a creature with an enchantment on it, and it gets +3/+3, first strike, vigilance, and lifelink. The combination of vigilance and lifelink is very, very strong against the zombie deck, as you will see. If I get this on a creature, basically it's a win. So, you'll see. These are, of course, good. More nice enchantments. More creatures that allow me to draw cards, which I like a lot. These are of course great because of the double strike. Another nice enchant creature. This one is it's pretty cheap and allows me to destroy the zombie enchantment if I get it early on, so I like it. It's cheap enough to keep in the deck. And some enchantments, some nice flying creatures. Pretty much I kept all the useful creatures in. Some nice big enchantments here. And these are great as well. These are great, allows me to search for an aura card, so I usually take the 2 aura cards you saw earlier, or take out a very strong aura card, and to win as well. Some other nice cards, and some big angels. And let me see... Oh, this card is really epic. It doubles your life if you damage a player with it. And I've had games where I had it on a double strike flying creature, and by the end of the game I had like 600 life. So it's pretty ridiculous card. It's a lot of fun. Okay, that's it. Let's play it to one or two games to show you all that this deck is Ramaz lean and mean. Let's go to the Morlun Zombie deck. Fight it with our Guardians of Light deck. T5 manas, bit much. Enchantment, no creatures. That's a new hand. One land is pretty crappy. It's not good enough either. Two lands, inexpensive cards. Okay. Well, we can do two things here. I can either concede and draw new, but I don't really like doing that, so even though the odds are a little bit against me now, I think I'm going to take this hand and I'm going to keep it. And I hope I get some early lands and hopefully a fast creature. If not, I'm pretty much screwed. Which would of course look kinda stupid because I was talking about winning 10 straight games in a row. But on the other hand, because I talked about it, I probably jinxed it and probably messed it up for myself. So I'm not going to get any land, just to warn you up front now. Probably going to lose this one. You know how it works. You say something like, well, luckily that didn't happen, and then it happens. So, oops. Maybe we get a few nice draws in. Let's keep the hope up. Land! Yay! Great. One more, please. Then I'm a happy camper. And we actually stand a chance. Let's rephrase that. If we get one more land, we win. Say that. Now look at my cards. Oh no, more damage. With this deck against the zombie jack, just take damage for a few turns and oh, we don't get a land. That's bad. Okay. And hope you get a nice big creature up soon. I'd like a small creature or a land, please. Land would be great. Land! Yay! Okay, let's see. Gonna play this one. He's of course going to attack, and I'm going to let both of them through again. So we get 6 life, which is pretty low, especially against the zombie deck. But we don't have a lot of choice here, because I need something to boost. Although if we do get another land, I could choose to play this one. I think that's a nice option as well. Allows me to block one more of his, and allows me to search a nice enchantment. Ooh, this is a difficult choice. Let's see here. I could play... make it a 4-4 flying. I could make it a 7-7 flying. Or I could play this one and get a really good enchantment. Take maybe one more zombie damage next turn and then win. Yeah. That's the best option. Because it allows me to take an enchantment I want, basically, and I'm going to take this one. Because it's so epic. I don't want to block next turn when he attacks, so better to attack now. Get that 2 damage in. I don't want to lose it to blocking next turn. Although I doubt he will attack. They're multiplying. No, more zombies. Ah, okay, he does. Cool. Probably because I'm low on life. So, on one hand it's bad to lose more life right now, on the other hand it's good that he's out. And we're going to basically do a nice turn now, hopefully. Hopefully get another land. That would be great. We really need land. Land! Okay. This is bad. If I play an enchantment, he can attack me with two of his zombies and I die. So I cannot do that. So I have to play this one. And hope I can save myself next turn by getting a land. Let's see what's a good combination with the other one I have. Protection from creatures is of course that we need this one. Okay. Let's see what happens now. Yeah, he takes 4. I can block 2 of them. I have to block another one. I'll take 2 damage. Okay. Not much we can do about that. If we get a land, we're fine. If we don't get a land, it's gonna be really tough. I think that's a loss, if we don't get a land. Land? Land! Yes! Okay, so we can play 2 things here. This one and this one, make it really big flying, get lifelink, and get a lot of land in. Or we play this one, and we give it +2/+3, and it cannot get through. So we need to play this one. It's gonna save us, I think. And then we play this one. And it's suddenly 10, 11, 14. And then we attack with vigilance. And lifelink. Oh, that was a tight spot there. Boom, 13 life. I like it. Back in action. And more zombies. Which is kind of a problem. He's probably going to... he's not going to attack. Whew. Which will allow us to destroy him now. Let's see which is the most fun to play. Could have done... No. Yeah, let's just make it humongous. Boom! What's that? It's a very big flying spirit guide. Boom! Woo! That was a close game there. Happy I won it. Don't want to look like an idiot for the video. Let's see what we got. Buyback. Okay. So I got Steel Zombies, but it's a 5 mana card, so it's not good enough for us. So what do? We take it out. Okay, that was a fun game. Let's do another one. Ramazgi. Three nice enchantments, very nice enchantments, but no creature. This is one of those hands that I prefer to play because it has 3 lands, which is kind of my favorite amount of lands in my beginning hand. It has a few very good cheap enchantments. Also one that gives us flying. The only thing we lack is a creature, and I have enough creatures in the deck, so we're gonna get one eventually. So I think this hand is good enough to win. Could have jinxed it there again, but who knows? Let's see what happens. appreciate. Ah, fuck. My bad. Oh, I thought I could play a character or a creature, and I actually hadn't. But it was okay. It was too expensive to play. Whew. More zombies. Okay. Play that land. Still no cheap creatures. Let's take another round of zombie beating. Go. Creature on the table. There we go. I was planning to play my enchantments on this one, but this one's also great. Creature and enchantments, or yeah, prefer to have another creature on the table. And double strike. Let's see. And we have the first damage in. Let's see what we do next turn. This is interesting. Basically I can give this one flying, but I could also give the +2/+2 to this one, because it has a double strike, and that will allow me to kill him all the more efficiently. Yeah, I'm going to put it on a double strike. I can give the other one a creature boost. Yeah, let's do that. There's protection from creatures now, so it's unblockable as well. So we can just bash on. Do some serious damage here. And hopefully kill him next turn. Boom, boom, boom. And we win. There we go. Boom. Let's see what card we get. We're winning fast, so I don't mind doing a quick third game for you, you guys, my viewers. Pariah, all damage we've been dealt is dealt to each other. It's a fun card. If I play it on a zombie, yeah, Okay, it allows me to kill one zombie, and for that it's a little bit expensive. So let's take that one out and do another game. It doesn't fit in my deck strategy. No, it doesn't. Go.
Ramaz.
Once more. Into the fray. Three lands. Early creature. Early creature. Good enough. Only thing we're lacking is a nice enchantment, which will come eventually. Well, being able to play two characters in turn 2 and 3 is really good. Sets up a nice base for killing him. I could decide to block him here because I have another creature I can boost with enchantments I will get, but I know he has a zombie that can retrieve another zombie from the graveyard when he plays it, so if I kill this one, he'll get it back next turn. In other words, don't block. There we go. Yay for lifelink. Very good. The start is there. And next turn we can search a random enchantment. So basically this is a win. Whee! Let's see, shall we do the 2 mana one, or next turn we have 6 mana, so we can also do a very big one. Let's do that for the fun. Where are the big ones? Big one, big one, big one, big one, big one. This one's fun. This one's fun. Yeah. Let's take the very big one. Sure. I don't mind eating your zombie. Thank you very much. He just wanted to get a zombie back, I guess. AI humor. Gotta love it. We have this one, and we play this one on that one. And double strike, also doubles the life doubling ability, as you will see shortly. We now have 14 life. ...28 life. 56! Chance there, you evil zombies. judge. And then we had 208 life. I love this game. Another idyllic tutor. No, you don't. Okay, that's it for now. I'd say thank you all for watching. If you like what you saw, or if you thought something was useful, please leave a like, a comment, or maybe even subscribe to my channel. Would really help help me build my my channel. Thanks again for watching, and see you all in my next videos. I'll be unlocking some other decks soon, and try to find some nice deck strategies there as well to unlock everything fast. See you all next time.